Hey guys, exams come at potentially the worst time of year for you. It is May, it is June, it is sunny, you want to be outside relaxing with your friends, but you are inside revising and you are going to be fasting as well. So today I'm here in London with the fabulous Amina and she's going to give you her top 10 tips for fasting during exams. Mm-hmm. So, number one.
So tip number one is to take time out to be spiritual. Now, there's a few different branches to this, and I think people don't usually talk about this, and they usually just say to revise and revise, and this is the one chance, and to do one exam, but really take your time out. So take 5 minutes to go and pray, or to read Quran, and don't forget that being educated and having an education is actually part of the religion. And the first word that was mentioned in the Quran was to read, and we're always told to stay educated, to increase your knowledge, to be a part of the society, whether that's being a doctor or a lawyer or a cleaner or whatever it is that you want to do to be part of society is in fact part of your religion. So by revising and by being a studious student, essentially you are doing worship, and that's something that I think people don't talk about much. But I think bear in mind that you take time out to not feel guilty and to make sure that you are, you know, completing your prayers or whatever it is that you want to do spiritually, but also make sure that you are rising and you've taken that time to think to yourself, well, this is actually beneficial for my life and it's also beneficial for me as a Muslim as well.
So, that's brilliant. Yeah. That's really, really good advice.
Yeah. I think people don't talk about it much, but I think that's the way I think about it, and I'm just like, you know what, I'm just rising and I'm being a good Muslim and I'm, you know, learning and I'm gaining knowledge and now I can give back and I'm giving back to society, and I think that's amazing.
That's so great.
Tip number two is to stay hydrated. I'm sure you say this to your kids all the time.
All the time, so important.
Yeah, stay hydrated. The number one cause of headaches is just dehydration, essentially. So obviously during the day you can't eat or drink. But you do have at least from 8 p.m. all the way to 3 a.m. You've got quite a few hours there where you should just keep hydrated. And one way to do this is by having maybe a bottle, like a 5 liter bottle or something, just a big bottle that you are going to finish that evening. And you won't sleep until you finish it. And by being hydrated, you can increase your concentration, you can maintain good revision efficiency, you can just be more efficient and just study better. If you're thirsty, you'll have a headache and you want to sleep and you just won't be able to study, and I mean, you can't really fix that during the day, you just wasted a day essentially. So yeah, stay hydrated is my number two tip.
Great. Yeah. And what about adding flavours to water?
Fine.
And stuff?
Yeah, just make sure you're drinking water, really.
What's your favourite flavour?
Honestly, I just like water by itself.
I'm really a fan of like really traditional blackcurrants.
Just water? Yeah. Okay, the third tip is do not miss your morning meals. So the morning meal we call suhoor, and it's the meal that you have between, any time before 3 a.m., about 3 a.m. in the UK. So do not miss it. I know we have a tendency to just sleep through it, and I do that a lot towards the end especially. Mm-hmm. But don't miss it. It really will allow you to eat something nutritious, drink some more water, and even you can even stay up a little bit more and just revise something really quickly after that as well. But yeah, definitely do not miss that meal. It's the one opportunity that you have to get something down you and just to kind of get rehydrated. Do not miss that meal, regardless of whether you have an exam the next day or you don't. Make sure you get up and have that meal. It's really, really important. So tip number four is, so going back to the meals, what should you eat? Now, you shouldn't need to be told this, but make sure that you're eating slow energy burning foods. So we were talking about this earlier.
This is a good tip.
Yeah.
All the time.
And what were you saying? What food was it?
Weetabix and bananas.
Exactly. Yep. Weetabix and bananas, so grains. Bananas are amazing, high in potassium. Dates are a really good one. I think as Muslims, we tend to have dates when we break the fast. Mm-hmm. That's like a sunnah, so it's a tradition that the Prophet used to do. But actually, having it when you start the fast is also really good because dates are slow burning energy and they're high in sugar, but it's natural sugar.
And it feels kind of like a little treat in the morning.
Yeah, exactly. Really, so I think people don't tend to do that in the morning, but actually I found it to be really, really useful. Having dates in the morning as well, just one or two is more than enough. Just trying to make sure that you get a good, nutritious, healthy meal. Not coffee, not caffeine, not sugar, not fried food, please no. Just things that are going to keep your stomach and your digestive system happy and healthy.
good food. What we don't want is for you to have loads of sugar, loads of caffeine, and then a few hours later, crash, and you'll feel absolutely awful. Yeah. So stuff that's going to sustain you throughout the whole day. Mm-hmm. Brilliant.
And my fifth tip and the last tip for this video is to sleep. Now, this is the one issue when it comes to fasting that it's really hard to get rid of, really, because you have to wake up in the middle of the night and all sorts. But make sure that you get your sleep. Now, there's a few ways of doing this. Number one is by napping in the middle of the day. Now, a nap means less than 20 minutes, not a 3-hour nap in the middle of the day. Less than 20 minutes, just put your, you know, close your eyes, put your head down, and just have a quick nap, and you'll wake up and you'll feel a lot more refreshed. So napping is definitely a good one. Or just make sure that you're not wasting time on social media, on your phones, on YouTube, on the internet. Just use that time instead to sleep. I think I get into bed and I've got half an hour and I'm just on my phone. Mm-hmm. That half an hour could be half an hour sleeping. So just make sure you maximize all the time you can to sleep. Without sleep, your concentration levels will be really low. You'll be tired. After a few days, you'll burn out completely. One other thing that I do, especially, I mean, I work, so I still have the same problem where I'm tired, is on the weekends to kind of get back to that sleep. So on the weekends where I don't have to wake up at 9 a.m., well, not even 9 a.m., 6 a.m. for work, get to work at 9 a.m., I just sleep until midday. Mm-hmm. So I've got my sleep back and I can rejuvenate on the weekend and then I'm ready for the weekday again. But yeah, definitely make sure that you're getting your sleep. I think that's one thing that I struggle with a lot, and I think by kind of having a good timetable and a good routine and good habits with sleep, it will really help with your revision and your exams as well.
That's great. I'm a big fan of having a nap. So if you had like an afternoon exam and you get home back from school, maybe like 3 o'clock, just like leave your phone downstairs, leave your phone in a separate room, just go and have a good 20 minute, half an hour, power nap. I'm a big, big fan of that. Yeah. We did say this was the top 10 tips for fasting during exams. That for the first 5.
Yes.
If you want the next 5,
my channel. Yeah. Come to my channel. I have a channel called I Am In A Place. And come over to me and see what the next 5 tips are. To help you revise and fast and have exams at the same time.
Good luck with your exams, guys. Remember, we are going to be here with you every single step of the way.
Yeah, best of luck. Happy fasting and happy revising.
Ouch. Love you too, Prim.